Hello and welcome to the third virtual performance platform. This one's a staff special. I contacted a few members of staff this week, some just didn't reply, but some said yes. So here are some performances from myself, Mr. Carter, Benjamin Conibear and Ms. Goode. There are also some excerpts from the interview with Dame Evelyn Glennie that I teased last week. I already have quite a few entries for next week, and I'm really excited about what else might land in my inbox this week, so keep them coming, please. I thought I'd kick this week off with myself. I've had a go at reproducing a song on Logic called I'll Be Okay by my favourite band, McFly. It's a good song with lyrics that might keep your spirits up in these times. I hope my version's all right. My music technicians will know how difficult I found this. Here you go. Next is an excerpt from the interview with myself and Dame Evelyn Glennie, in which we talk about creativity.
Creativity meant to you?
Well, I think that we're all creative beings. You know, as soon as we're born, we're curious about everything and we're soaking everything up. And when we're infants, you know, it's the most extraordinary thing when you watch really, really young people and just having this innate freedom. And they're improvising without realizing that they're improvising, you know, because everything is new, everything is a discovery. And it's trying to keep that innate feeling of discovery and curiosity. And I suppose fearlessness, we lose very easily that feeling of just this curious landscape that we all have when we're younger. And I think that, you know, we get into a state where either something is right or wrong, or it's judged in some kind of way, or you like it or you don't like it. And that's a real shame, because that's all about putting barriers up. So I think I find, you know, my love of music and sound is just having this freedom. And I mean, I'm sort of looking up at the moment and I'm seeing my shelves of instruments. And you know, one of the things that this kind of lockdown has done for me, because all of the concerts and events have evaporated from the diary, you know, it's given me a chance to work on the instrument collection and, you know, listing all the instruments and things like that. And I'm sort of getting to know certain instruments that I haven't picked up in a long time. It could be a little shaker. It could be a damaru, a Tibetan drum. It could be a metal tongue drum. It could be you know, a rattle. It could be all sorts of things. And I think, ah, oh, right, now, what is this again? What can I do with this, you know? And it, that's a lot of fun. So I've actually had a really nice time over the past week. And that's really what's important for me in creativity, is keeping that childlike curiosity. And we hear that quite a lot, but it really is that.
Here's for the next staff performance. It's of Somewhere Only We Know, performed by Ms. Goode. She recorded both the piano and the vocals at home. Here you go.
I once crossed an empty land. I knew the pathway at the back of my hand. I felt the earth beneath my feet. Sat by the river and it made me complete. Oh, simple thing, where have you gone? I'm getting old and I need something to rely on. So tell me when you're gonna let me in. I'm getting tired and I need somewhere to begin. I came across a fallen tree. I felt the branches of them looking at me. Is this the place we used to love? Is this the place where I've been dreaming of? Oh, simple thing, where have you gone? I'm getting old and I need something to rely on. So tell me when you're gonna let me in. I'm getting tired and I need somewhere to begin.
Chunk of interview with Dame Evelyn Glennie is one in which I talk about flower pots. I have included a YouTube link to the piece that we talk about in the description.
I've been listening to your podcast, which is fantastic, by the way. Absolutely love it.
It's all very new ground for me, so
it's amazing. So interesting.
Thank you.
So interesting. That's something that I want to ask you about. You mentioned to Bill Bailey about all these new pieces that you've been playing, and particularly one where there was four-tuned flower pots. That sounds incredible.
Oh, the flower pots, yes. Oh, that I've played for years and years and years. And it's a piece by Frederick Rozeski, the American composer. And it's literally for four tuned flower pots. And he's specified the general pitches. But if you can't find those pitches, not to worry. So it's just an idea of the intervals. And just straightforward terracotta flower pots or whatever, you know, pitches you can find. But flower pots that you can sit on the floor and play, and you basically narrate a poem, a Greek poem. And it's a very interesting musical experience, simply because the pots, you know, are pretty fragile things, really. You know, if you strike it too hard, you're going to crack it. If you drop it, it's going to break, and so on. And but yet we're all familiar with flower pots. And it sort of diminishes the line between percussionist, musician, and the general public, because when an audience sees this piece being played, they think, well, hold on a second, I could do that, you know, I can strike a flower pot. And so they may go home and they strike their own flower pots. They think, oh, wow, you know, so I can see that. And the sound is very fragile as well, because, you know, dynamically, it's nothing is too loud, because you can't just, you know, strike a flower pot as you would a bass drum. Mm. So the loudest of the flower pot is actually not that loud, but yet it's present. But the softest can just be a whisper, you know, it can just be a tiny little, like a little star, and that's it, and it's gone. So, yeah, it's a very interesting piece. I don't know, it might be on YouTube, I've no idea.
How do you tune a flower pot?
You don't. You just go into home base or a garden centre and
hit them all and hope.
Yeah, just pick the ones that you think are going to work.
That's amazing. I really like the idea that it's just something so accessible that people can just do themselves.
Absolutely.
The next staff performance comes from Mr. Benjamin Conibear with his clean version of Loving Is Easy by Rex Orange County. He recorded all the parts at home, but then again, he is the school's music technician, so nice job, Benjamin. Interview was a giggle with me talking to Dame Evelyn about her very own Scottish tartan.
You've overcome adversity, gained international acclaim, performed with some huge names, helped open the Olympics, gained considerable funding for music education, been awarded an OBE, or a Polar Music Prize winner, have countless other accolades, but perhaps your most significant achievement is having, for more than 20 years, a registered tartan. What's the thread count?
Well, it is a registered tartan, and it's called The Rhythms of Evelyn Glennie.
That's incredible.
And it took about a year to register in Edinburgh, because they have to make sure that there isn't the same combination of colours and weave in your pattern. And because there are so many tartans out there, and several of them look alike, it can just be a subtle difference. And so they have to check all of this. And so mine is a, in fact, I think I might, hold one second. Yes.
Oh, wow.
That's my one. So it's bright, it's red, lots of yellow, purple, a little bit of black going through. And so I'd probably say this is more a feminine tartan, to be honest. However, that's, you know, it's open to all people. And this is a little hat. So yes, it's that's what it is. There we are.
And the last little bit of interview with Dame Evelyn Glennie to share with you is her wise words to you all about how to survive the current lockdown.
Finally, have you got any kind of words of wisdom for any of our students at home making music?
Really, I think we're all in the same situation where we have a chance to really connect with our instruments and with the sound world of our home, of our environment, and really, you know, thinking how lucky are we to have this opportunity, you know, to relate to something and to be able to focus our time or our attention, to be able to share what we do with other people through technology during this time. So, you know, although we're in lockdown, we have a lot of positives that we can draw from this and just use this time as being the most creative period that you have. Let's not waste it at all and just really have a good time. You know, you've got a chance to, I suppose, not feel pressured as such, but to really enjoy this moment of creativity, this moment of exploration, of curiosity, and of kind of looking up in a way. So even although there might be the four walls there, you have a chance to actually look up as opposed to look down all of the time. And really, it could be a very creative time.
And I have saved the best till last. Today's final performance comes from Isca's resident rapper, Mr. C, performing his own penned words. Here we go.
Isca Performance Platform 2020. This is Mr. C, coming live and direct from my living room. Hope you're all doing okay. Here we go. It's just one of those days, the kind you just let float away, when all the things that people say are simply in one ear and out the other. We overcomplicate more than sit and contemplate, so everybody concentrate and see what we come up with. Amounts to nothing, we can probably just bluff it. Life's never smooth, but don't stress about the roughness, getting the job done or mental toughness, cause now's the moment for us to do much less. Savor every breath, tell me why you wanna rush this. Want every little thing to go your way? Tough tits. Who do you think you are? What do you reckon's going on here? How did you figure we all ended up on this one sphere? It's unclear, more certain where we're headed. If we don't stop dead in our tracks and get our balance, gotta find a better way of dealing with the planet's malice. The way things go down is so cold and so callous today. Another day rolls in, what's the point in even trying? I know what it's like, conditions ripe for a lion, but the reason for rising could be just over the horizon. It's in the mind we decide if we're living or dying. Today the flex is putting into perspective all the things in life that we find so hectic. There ain't a problem that can't be corrected, or a good thing that we got that won't go bad if we neglect it. Times we wanna hide, outside it's bedlam. It's hard to make a change from the confines of your bedroom. Yes, to get ahead you got to get yourself some headroom, but once that's done, we got to make those tired legs move. I know what you're thinking, and I'm no Mr. Motivator. We don't release the beast right now, it's bottled up for later, and later might not be the luxury we can rely on. It's time to strike whatever the temperature of the iron today. Today is forever, time has never been linear. Pick a point, any point, and say, hey, I'm beginning here. Got to make a start on my mark before I disappear. The only thing my mission will be missing is fear. Hate to labor the point, but let's make this clear. In control of my own soul, no higher power steers. An anarchistic spirit through the arrows and spears, giving a wide berth to any narrow-minded peers. Paddling the shallows of ideas where I dive in. Life's a journey, but today I'm arriving. Destination unknown, hope this generation condones these attempted explanations sent in two microphones. We are not alone, and yet we feel so far apart. Getting it together is inherent in this art. We connect like Scots to TVs, trying to relate to a mind state that's so nice and easy today. Stay safe, everybody. Plenty of vitamin C. Take it from me. Stay indoors and give the NHS workers your applause.
And that's all for today, everyone. Like I said, I've got a few for next week already, but remember, you can send absolutely any submissions to me at jvallance@iscarexeter.co.uk. I'm really loving hearing what you're all up to. Keep them coming. Stay safe, everyone, and have a happy Easter.